To make a video.
Let me see here. Wait. No, that's no good.
Oh no! I don't have any video games. If only I could buy some with this money.
Never fear, young sir, for there is a place you can go to buy video games that nobody else wanted for pennies on the dollar. The Thrift Store!
Goodwill Games, part one of... Who knows if I'll make another one, actually.
But up next is also something that if you were a kid in the 90s, you probably remember, I Spy. More specifically, I Spy Spooky Mansion. Deluxe. For the PC.
I Spy was a series of books that had pictures with many objects on each page. The goal was to find the objects listed in a rhyme on the bottom. All the pictures were incredibly well put together and had composition that even today still impresses me. Oh, and this book you're looking at right here? I also got this at a thrift store. Just figured that was worth noting. Let's take a look at the back of the case here. System requirements. Pentium 2 266 megahertz or faster processor? Oh no! This game obviously plays a lot like the books. I thought it would be easy, but it's actually kind of tricky.
A spoonful of bugs.
Well, sometimes. Like this one. I gotta find three horns. I found this one, and everyone in the comments are probably gonna call me an idiot, but I can't for the life of me find the other two anywhere. Oh, horns! Game, you tricky!
If you dare to come back in, a new adventure will begin.
No thanks, dude. Last time you locked me into the house and you wouldn't let me out. So I don't think I'm gonna fall for that one again. I'm not that stupid. But hey, I mean, it could be pretty fun. I guess, why not? Let's go! His voice then just sort of fades into nothing, and Barbie, clearly not paying any attention at all, says,
"As of today, I'm reporting as Barbie, world-class explorer."
And by world-class explorer, what she actually means is, I'm gonna run in a straight line for an unnecessarily long amount of time and pick up meaningless items all while controlling like a sack of fecal matter. Because that's all this game is. I was hoping I'd be able to talk quite a bit about this one, but honestly, that's all there is to it. What I am showing you right now, that's it. Well, that and Barbie getting trampled by an elephant. Also, she can do this. So that's cool.
Hey everybody, I'm Peanut Butter Gamer, and I think it's about time we did another Goodwill Games video. Once upon a time, you could walk into a thrift store and find some really cool stuff, like a boxed copy of Donkey Kong 64, or a random NES gem, or anything good. At all. But these days, anything that's actually worth something is usually sold on the internet, so there's not too much to get excited about. But hey, who knows? Maybe we'll find something good.
Either my game isn't running correctly, or we have our first casualty already. No, not Dorothy Ann! Why couldn't it have been Arnold? I think it's broken. Well, I fixed it, but now it looks like this. Don't tell me what to do. I guess my computer just isn't powerful enough to run a game made in 1995. But at least it has a door, so that's pretty cool.
And up last, we have Mia, the search for Grandma's Remedy. And with box art like this, you know it's gotta be good.
Let me tell you a story about a little mouse.
Oh goody, a poop spider is singing to me. Just what I always wanted. And that's actually all I've got, because other than the intro video and the tutorial, I couldn't get the game to work. But oh well, I found a slightly newer version of the game that I actually could get to work, Mia, Romaine's New Hat. This game's intro, while not quite as creepy as the poop spider, is slightly terrifying. Mia, would you get that can, please?
Okay.
You did it. Shortly after that, my game glitched out and Mia got stuck in some dish soap. And despite saving multiple times, there was no data for the game at all once I restarted, so I'm just gonna take this as divine intervention.
You don't have to play anymore.
It's a brand new day. The sun is shining. Everybody's happy. It's the perfect day to get out there and do whatever it is that you love. What do I love? Well, I'm glad you asked. Silver Steve's clocks. Experts agreed, it has what you need. As long as all you need is to tell time.
Oh, hold on one second. Hello? Hello? Hello?
What do you mean the clock people said no on the brand deal? I already did it! It went great! You can't do this to me, I really need the money. Look, if that's the way you want to be, then we're through!
As I was just saying a few minutes ago, one of my all-time favorite things to do is to save money. So I went to the thrift store and got a few games for you guys. I think it's gonna be a whole lot of fun. Let's go ahead and get started. Up first, I found a game called Arthur's Absolutely Fun Day for the Game Boy Color. As a kid who grew up without cable, I actually really liked Arthur and I watched it all the time. There wasn't really a whole lot of other options. But this show will always have a really special place in my heart. Heck, I still remember the entire theme song by heart. And I say, hey, what a wonderful kind of day. Where you can learn to work and play and get along with each other. I could definitely continue with that, but I guess I'll spare you guys this time. I can't imagine that an Arthur game for the Game Boy Color would be very good, but hey, as the song says, you gotta listen to your heart, listen to the beats. Let's play it! Alright, Arthur's Absolutely Fun Day, here we go! Well, for starters, it's pretty ugly. I'm not so sure about this puke green background here. And looking at Arthur on this roller coaster, I think he's seen better days. Although he still looks better than he does in the books. Ugh. Wow, Arthur's got quite the arm for an 8-year-old. Steph Curry! Dang, are you kidding me? Just look at that strength! Arthur's a beefcake, confirmed. And every time Arthur makes a shot, he gets real happy. Now we're delivering newspapers. Arthur's putting that beefy arm to good use. And just look at these curves on his throws. Forget basketball. I think Arthur's got a future in baseball. Determined to live up to the name of the game and have the absolute most fun day ever to be had, Arthur wants to go everywhere. He wants to go to the library. He wants to visit his grandma. He wants to see the Taj Mahal, Hyrule Field, the final boss of Black Temple, and even the fiery pits of hell. If it exists, Arthur wants to go there. So, I just played air hockey with Buster a whole lot because it's the only game that is even almost equivalent to fun. And in the process, I even mastered my special signature shot, the glitchy corner shot. I'm telling you, it's legit. Why a theme park would give free tickets to kids for playing air hockey at an unaffiliated arcade and making a few hoops on their household basketball goal, I have no idea. But hey, I'm not complaining. But I will complain about this theme park. It sucks. The games range from incredibly easy to practically impossible. And despite it looking fairly simple, I could not hit anything on this Knock the Clown into the Water game. I take back what I said about Arthur playing baseball because this is a pretty pathetic display. Okay, the game's not that great, but the real problem here is Arthur. Why does he have to insert himself in everyone's lives? Don't you think that's a bit arrogant? Maybe the brain wanted to sort these books by himself. Maybe Francine would like to take a shot every once in a while. And maybe, just maybe, Buster would like to win a freaking air hockey game. Oh, but no, the game's called Arthur's Absolutely Fun Day. I'd hate to rain on Arthur's parade. Hey, everybody, Arthur's having fun. Good for Arthur, right?
or a freaking jerk!
Oh no!
As some of you may know, I have a puppy, Azura, named after the Daedric Prince Azura in the Elder Scrolls. So I'm just gonna recreate her.
It's a perfect resemblance.
I'm so proud.
What's the point of this? There's not even anything to do. It's like Nintendogs, but all the fun stuff taken out. I'd tell you what I'm thinking, but this little dog face says it better than I ever could.
Please kill me.
And even worse, she isn't even winning the beauty contest anymore. What happened? She also stopped moving.
I guess not feeding or watering her would do that.
Stop being dead, puppy. Stop! Bad dog!
Bad boy.
Good boy. Fire! Fire! Oh god, why? Why did this always happen to me? Fire!
Somewhere.
I don't like this game. It's scary.
Hey! It worked!
I don't have disc 2. This is over. We're done. It's a cliffhanger. It's up to interpretation. What do you think happened to Mia? Did she fly off into space and save the day, save her house? Or did she just rip up in space-time and dead? Probably that one. I'm gonna go with that one. Let me know what you think happened to her in the comments.
You got to listen to your heart, listen to the beat, listen to the rhythm of the street. Open up your eyes, open up your ears, get together and make things better by working together.
Should I keep going?
No.
It's a simple message,
no.
And it comes from the heart. Oh, believe in yourself. But that's the place to start. Todd and I say, hey.
The neighbors are calling the police.
Hello, everybody. I'm Peanut Butter Gamer, and welcome to my list of the top 10 most expensive games ever made.
Just hold on a second. I gotta check my bank account.
What the? Azura? Since when are you a hot dog? Where did you get that costume from? What is that? A sack of gold? Did you get into my credit card again? Did you steal my credit card?
Luca, you too? A burger? What? Why are you a burger? Where'd you get a freaking? Wait, how do you don't have money? Ah! How could you? How could this be?
Well, there goes that idea. Guess I'm going to the thrift store to buy some games now. Be right back.
And I say, hey, what a wonderful kind of day, where you can learn to work and play, and get along with each other.
Hey! Watch it, you stupid fart! Get out the road! Shit! Hey, Pete.
All right, let's see what we got here. Up first is...
this game.
What's this? Ever Girl? Ever Sporty, Ever Style, Ever Party, Ever Adventure?
Alright!
Adventure! Yeah! I don't think this girl needs to worry too much about what she's gonna do with her life because she's clearly magic. Before we move on, I just want to point out how much I love these loading screens. No, not the way they look, and no, not the super cool words written in the background.
Ever excellent, ever inspire,
ever... whatever? Okay, I actually do like that one. I love how short they are. You walk from one part of the map to another, the loading screen pops up for a split second with this super catchy music, and then it's instantly gone. This happens all the time throughout the entire game. I think the TV broadcast sounds right up my alley, so let's try that. We need to keep the camera on the ball, obviously, but according to the instructions, we also have to keep the camera on the sponsors to keep them satisfied. Now, I understand, sponsors pay the bills, I get it, but this is completely ridiculous. In order to win this minigame, you have to not only keep your camera on the ball, you also have to move it directly to the sponsor 1 and sponsor 2 signs, and hold them there for quite some time. During the middle of the game! And if you ignore them for too long, these bars go down to 0 and you lose.
Oh, what a beautiful game of soccer we have here!
Emily's moving towards the goal and...
oh, hold on just one second here. Make sure to sign up to Loot Crate with my link in the description below.
Alright, I'm satisfied. After you try everything, you pick whichever activity you like best and then go to the mall to buy something for it. Seriously though? Not only do you want me to help you with your stupid broadcast, you also want me to buy a video camera to use with my own money? Do you know how much a good camera costs? This could set me back thousands of dollars! Alright, well, I guess we got more Goodwill Games videos coming in the future then. Hope you guys like these things. Anything for you, my best friend Emily that I've only spoken to once. Oh wait, is her name Ashley? I think I've been calling her Emily this whole time. Literally 15 seconds before it happened, I was imagining how much cooler this would be if I was snapping pictures of a UFO or something, and then a freaking alien popped out from behind a tree. I'm not making this up. I'm serious. Ugh.
Why would you do that? Why would you do that? Oh, come on! Freaking move! Freaking move! Oh, come on!
Get out of my way! Get out of my way! Get out of my way! Get out of my way!
Oh! I didn't even hit that!
Emily is the one who talked me into this stupid... I don't even know why I talked to her.
Congratulations! You've chosen well! Remember, it doesn't matter the path you take, it's that you've decided what's right for you.
And that is the story of how Sarah Fanny became the Iron Girl!
Oh wait, is it the Golden Girl? Is it the Iron Girl or the Golden Girl? We need some consistency here. All right, Evergirl. That was pretty cool, I guess. Except for the parts that weren't. It was at least an interesting concept, but once I realized that it was just the same formula repeated over and over, it kinda lost me. Arthur's Thinking Games? Another Arthur game? I freaking love Arthur! Arthur! What the heck is up with this song? They made a game about a show with the best intro theme ever made? And instead of using that, they went with this?
Arthur.
Okay, I think it's frozen. After a few hours, I finally got it working. Seriously, I spent hours getting Arthur's frickin' Thinking Games to work properly. I need to rethink my life. They also interrupt each other from time to time.
Don't test me, Arthur. You may be my favorite, but I am not a very stable man. Okay?
And then we've got... Ah, jeez. I've watched, I think, literally every episode of the show at least 5 times growing up, and I still can't remember this girl's name.
How about... Harrietta?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Oh, jeez. What did I do?
Ratburn's game is not a game at all, it's a quiz. I'm not falling for your crap, Ratburn. This game may be ages 5 and up, but I assure you I'm way closer to the up. I'm more in the up range. I'm 26. I'm also not really buying these lines from Arthur either.
Wow, who's playing?
Come on, Arthur, where's the enthusiasm?
Wow, Arthur. That was so good.
But I did find it amusing that Muffy couldn't get a single answer right.
What shape has 3 corners?
Line? A line? You're lucky your family earns 95% of the income in Elwood City because you're not getting too far in life with your intellect, clearly.
Line!
Good job!
Let's try another!
What at all?
What?
What at all? What at all?
What at all?
Well, I know I'm not going with Muffy's answer, so... circle?
Circle. Excellent, Francine.
Yes! A circle, I knew it! I used the force, and I knew it! Take that and eat it with your breakfast, Ratburn! Your game sucks!
Okay.
Hey, kid, you're good.
I work with money for a living. What is my job?
A fireman.
A fireman.
Hey everybody, I'm Peanut Butter Gamer, and welcome to the fifth installment of the Goodwill Games series. Wow, everyone's so impressed with my abilities to make videos in a reasonably efficient and sufficient manner. Yeah. Thank you everybody, you flatter me too much.
Subscribe.
Oh, just ignore that, that's not supposed to be there. Do it! Seeing as Goodwill Games has always been a show where I try to save you, my precious viewer, as well as myself, I guess, some hard-earned cash by showing off some cheap, obscure, and often weird thrift store games that nobody else wanted. I mean, good games. Always good games, of course. I decided to celebrate this milestone by showing off some other thrift store things that I found while looking for these games. So let's do it. I didn't find anything else. There's nothing good at the thrift stores. But I also really loved Elmo. In fact, even to this day, he remains one of my favorite childhood TV characters. No, Arthur. I said one of my favorite characters. You're still at the top of the list. Don't worry.
I would never do that to you, Arthur. Okay?
After a catchy song and a pretty sweet dance with Blanket, we're forced to make a choice. Do we want to play on easy mode or hard mode? And that's actually a pretty difficult decision because I hear if you die in Grouchland, you die in real life. I can neither confirm nor deny this, but that is the word going around the playground. So just be careful out there, everybody. Did you really think I couldn't find anything else super cool and amazing at the thrift store? Well, if you did, you're dead wrong because the other day I found something super hype. And it was basically a steal too for the low, low price of $2.99 US dollars. I bought 1,000 hours of free America online internet. The best free dial-up money can buy. Get jealous. Hey, we didn't show the registration code on there, did we? I actually need this. The second game I have for you guys today is... Excuse me. Sonic's Schoolhouse. I know a lot of you guys love seeing me talk about Sonic. I don't know why, because I don't like it. But I have a feeling that this isn't gonna be a normal Sonic game anyway, so let's just get right into it.
I'm Sonic.
It also makes me wonder exactly what kind of sick individual would force their friend to play this with them. Because that's apparently a thing you can do. But no worries, the actual game, of course, is not actually as creepy as the main menu makes it seem like it'll be.
Let's go back to school.
All right, I'm done with this.
You're gonna come back soon, right?
No. Probably never, actually. At the start of the video, I briefly mentioned early childhood memories. Well, there's one game that I have just the vaguest memory of playing when I was a kid. Or rather, I should say, I have the vaguest memory of not being all allowed to play it as a kid, and instead watching my older brother play it because I was too young to read. But luckily, I've got that covered. I learned just how to do it last week. For the longest time, I tried to remember exactly what that game was called, but I never could. I even asked on Twitter a few times to no avail. All I remember was that you were some red spacesuited guy flying around on a jet bike or something. You know, that game. But after looking at this box, I realized that I had finally found it. Treasure Galaxy. Unfortunately, this guy over here, named the Master of Mischief, decides to launch a bunch of weird-faced asteroids at it. I think the word mischief might be a bit too lenient of a descriptor for bombarding a city with giant face asteroids, though, I'm sorry to say. I think it would be, what's that word again? Oh yeah, terrorism. The Master of Terrorism. Maybe that's a bit too much for a kid's game, though. During the deadly assault, the mischief. Now this is the part of the game that I remember watching my older brother play. Flying around on the space shooter and catching little star guys with yellow circle beams. I'm actually getting a little bit nostalgic just looking at this.
You've earned some Starbucks.
Yes! I know what you're thinking. What is it that makes this star drop cool and this one not cool? Well, it's obviously because the uncool ones don't have a giraffe neck. A neck like a giraffe. Well, the game may not have been that much fun. It was made for 3-year-olds, I guess. But it was a nice trip down memory lane, and I'm glad that I finally got to play it. It only took like 24 years. Finding a game like this is one of the reasons why I love going to thrift stores and yard sales in the first place. You never know what cool stuff you might find. And in celebration of the 5th episode of this little series, I just wanted to give a genuine shout out to you guys for not only watching these Goodwill Games videos, but for watching all of the content that I put out. Making these videos is not only what I enjoy doing most, it also occupies most of my thoughts almost every day, pretty much constantly. In fact, I'm not sure I'll ever be able to accurately express just how much the support you give means to me. So instead, I'll just say this. We will always be
together forever. The world seems fine. We never would ever leave you behind.
Yeah!
And you're cute.
All right, let's start this video off with a bang. The meteor rocket.
It's gonna go like that, and it's gonna go like that, and then it's...
Launch one. Launch two!
Oh. Oh. That didn't go very well.
You know, some people these days prefer to look up their information on the internet, but I, on the other hand, prefer the old-fashioned method. CD-ROMs!
Infopedia 2.0. The ultimate multimedia encyclopedia and reference library.
Some things never get old. Except they literally do, I guess. So shouldn't say that. Hey, could you look something up for me?
You bet I can!
Hi, I'm the Infopedia Librarian, here to show you just how easy it is to use all of Infopedia's amazing features.
Photographs, videos, animations, maps, sound clips, world facts, and morphing maps. You won't just research people, places, and events. You'll experience them.
Algeria has a population of 27,895,000.
A sextant is an optical instrument used in navigation.
A tetrahedron is a polyhedron that has 4 faces.
The San Andreas Fault in California is a line dividing 2 plates of the Earth's crust.
Moon, name given to the natural satellite of the Earth and sometimes applied to the satellites of the other planets in the solar system. The diameter of the moon is about 3,000 variation in frequency of any emitted wave. Such as a wave spacecraft, of heating effects because of friction become important.
The economy of Trinidad and Tobago is based on the production and refining of petroleum.
A geological landform consisting of a fissure in the Earth's crust of electromagnetic radiation, having a shorter wavelength than light, and
the cone is formed by the deposition of molten or solid matter that flows or is ejected through the central stage of the Earth.
Titmouse, common name for small songbirds of the genus Parus family Paradise. Although this was traditionally the names for members of the families, although the only bird still caged collar called titmouse are crested in North America. Hey, what did you want me to look up again?
Huh? Oh, I already Googled it like 20 minutes ago.
Stupid millennials.
Now everyone will love you because you have Infopedia 2.0. You know stuff!
Up next, I found this! Breath of the Wild bow! I mean, there's not really anything to say about this one. I'm just gonna test it out, so let's go ahead and, I'll get it open and then we'll shoot some stuff, I guess.
Alright, a new Breath of the Wild bow. I can only imagine how well I'll be able to smite all my enemies with this thing. I can see it now.
Dang. I missed. It turns out that this thing kind of sucks. It only shoots like 5 feet. So if you see it, maybe don't buy it. Oh, this is the cheapest looking thing I've ever seen. It looks so sturdy on the box. I'm disappointed. It's taped together. This is scotch tape. I'm going back to the store and I'm gonna demand my money back. How much did I pay for this? Like $2? Give it back! Where's my $2, Cole? I don't know why that joke of all the jokes I have done is the one that always comes back. Who owned this and was like, this still works. I can take this to the thrift store. Someone else will want this. I'm gonna have to get some tape myself to keep this thing up together. Like, it's not gonna work. They say duct tape can fix everything, but I'm not sure even duct tape's gonna save this thing. This piece of garbage. These are just straws. Like, literally, you could break them.
just by squeezing them. How is this supposed to stay together? Ah, there it goes. I finally got it to fit in. I think this might do it.
I don't know where he's going. I guess he's just done now.
I couldn't take my eye off of this when I saw it at the thrift store. I have no idea if it's fun or not. But here it is! Bear!
Bear! It's a bear.
He doesn't even really have a name. Well, there it is. Hungry Bear Feeding Game with Pump Grip Action. It just says sharper image all over it. I have no idea if this is fun. It says it makes sounds. So we're just gonna open it up, I guess, and then we'll shoot it in the face. I think you shoot it into the mouth there, like so. To be honest, it looks like one of those things that, like, Sharper Image just has a bunch of these bear toys in their stock, and they're like, what do we do with this? We gotta sell it. And there you go. Hungry Bear Feeding Game. Come out, bear, be free!
Hello? Hello?
Todd, help me, Todd, I'm stuck.
Just a joke. Here he is. Is he gonna come on? Oh, okay, he came on. What noises does he make? Make a noise! Oh, there's the noise. That would look weird. I was just trying to get the tongue to make the noise. There we go. Center that. It only sometimes wants to do it. Is it the same sound every time? Oh, hold on. I swear it said that it makes sounds. Which would mean multiple different sounds. Never mind, it just says with sound. It doesn't say sounds. You gotta read the fine print, everybody. How did that not go in?
It didn't go in.
How did that not go in? I want a replay on that. The tongue bounced it out. Ah, oh, come on.
Woo!
Whiff come
city.
On.
Whiff city.
Let's just say it would be much more accurate to call it Mario practices typing too. But anyway, I'm getting a little ahead of myself here. Whose job was it to come up with all this stuff anyway? Apparently it was somebody that really likes sports and deadly earthquakes.
That's pretty weird.
Seriously, we went from typing about movies and football to talking about an earthquake where, quote, hundreds of people were killed. And then it goes on to talk about atomic bombs being dropped on Japan. I'm feeling a little bit of whiplash from this transition here.
Oh yeah, I almost forgot. You know that talking, floating Mario head?
Say, I'm hungry. Have you got any food?
Yeah, that one.
Well, this is the game that it came from. I don't really have anything else to say about it, mostly because I don't want to look at it anymore. The whole disembodied head thing is kind of freaky. And I found the thumbnail for my video already.
I don't really understand memes, but cursed image? Does that apply? I think it does. Freaking terrorist Koopa over here. Sheesh. Now that is one smug castle. He's gonna get his later though, don't worry.
I know a game that'll generate a lot of new viewers through the YouTube algorithm. Twisted the Game Show for the 3DO Interactive Multiplayer System. You know, the trending game.
Alright, whatever, let's just do it.
Twisted is a game show-themed party game that takes full advantage of the 3DO console's full motion capabilities. And just as a side note, I wasn't able to find an actual 3DO console at a thrift store, so I just bought this one off eBay. Hopefully that's not cheating.
Oh wait, I don't care! I make the rules, and you guys can't do anything about it! Other than call me an idiot in the comments, and that's not gonna bother me at all.
You suck!
No, I don't even want to hear it! Get back on the wheel of torture!
Torture. You'd think that at least this board game would be an actual game instead of a quiz, but you would be very much wrong about that if you were to be thinking it. Yeah, you're a living, breathing, sentient board game that apparently can also read. We're all so impressed.
But if you don't mind, my grandma is dying. She's dying. Okay, so could you just hurry it up already?
You'll have to play again. You want some sparklies?
Not only does this heartless miscreant not give a crap about grandma, he's also a freaking cheat!
Now you may think that I'm being sarcastic or trying to cover up for a legitimate mistake I made, and I admit, that does sound like something I would do. But I have evidence to back me up. As you can see, I land on this space here, so of course I put my mouse over cactus to click and drag it up, but instead, it pulls up hot dog!
Sorry!
Freaking cheat! Caught in the act!
No point for you!
Shut up! Don't talk to me ever again!
Hello? What's your name?
It's a freaking cuckoo clock, you idiot!
And I guess this is it. After all these years, we're finally going to beat a Mia game. We didn't encounter any game-breaking glitches. I have the second CD. It's all lined up perfectly. I don't know what's gonna happen, but I'm so excited. Here it comes!
Hop on! Great! Thank you for your help. I never could have done this without you. Bye!
Are you serious? Nothing's happening. That's it? After all this time, we finally beat a Mia game, and that's it? Nothing happens? I don't care how old this game is, I'm gonna file an official complaint. Visit our website at kutoka.com. Okay, I will. Thank you very much.
Wait, Kutoka 1995 to 2017, they closed down? You know, I joke around about these games a lot, but I actually do kinda like them. They're pretty good kids' games.
Rest in peace, Kutoka. You will be missed. I'm feeling a little bit sad for a lot of reasons, but I can't lie, one of the reasons I'm sad is that I really want all these Mia toys. I didn't even know these things existed, and now that I finally know that they exist, I can't buy them anymore. They've got these plushies. They've got these little figurines, stickers. They had stickers, and I didn't buy any. You know what? That's it. It's just like, all right, we're done. All right, we're done, everybody. Mario, wrap it up for us.
Okay. Bye bye.
I was gonna start the video, but I got a little bit distracted with my first fly bar. Only $1.99 from the thrift store.
Yeah.
This is the best day of my life!
These are always some of my favorite videos to make. If you haven't seen them before, long story short, I go to thrift stores and find a bunch of random
really good games purchased at a great value.
And then I play them.
Maybe we'll go to the airport and have some fun. Maybe we'll go to the airport, come on everyone. Maybe we'll go to the airport, except maybe not, because the airport sucks.
Seriously though, I really wish I had found one of the other two games, because the airport is just about the last place in the entire world that I would want to explore. With the qualifier that I wouldn't have to go to the airport to get on a plane in order to get there. I mean, obviously I wouldn't want to be dropped off in the middle of the Sahara Desert or something. But I genuinely cannot think of a place that I would rather be less. Come back to me on this.
Okay, I got this one. You'll like it. It's a purple convertible, yeah. This car can take you to the moon, man.
It's a putt-putt reference. I love you, putt-putt.
Before we move on to the next game, how about we find one more item?
Now, let's see if you can find it!
Ah, easy peasy, we already know where this one is.
It's not working?
Oh no, don't tell me we have to click over 800 times until it gets back to zero. We do.
We'll eventually get there. Come on! Okay. Oh god. The days are going by so fast!
Ah, ah. I don't know if I'm gonna make it!
All this time and I still haven't thought of a place I'd rather be less than the airport, so I asked you guys on Twitter to help me out. Let's see if I can find some good responses. 836 replies. You guys have nothing better to do, apparently. It's okay, neither do I. That's why I decided to make videos in the first place. A lot of people are saying the doctor's office. I'm gonna have to hard disagree on that, because if I'm at the doctor's office, there's a chance I'm gonna get sick, which would mean I have an excuse to get out of whatever it is I had to go to the airport for. I think some people did not read the rules here. North Korea, how am I gonna get to North Korea without going to the...
You know what? It's okay. I can't follow instructions either. People are coming at like very, very specific situations where it's like, I'm talking about more of a general situation. Not like at the park when there's a bomb dropping. Like, that doesn't count.
Buried alive? That, yeah, I don't know if that counts, but if it does, sure.
Prison. That one does technically count. So yeah, I got prison. Some people said prison, so prison. Mostly just because I have to move on to the next segment though. Because if you could just go and then come home, they wouldn't be that bad. So you didn't specify that you have to stay there. I don't know. Who cares? All right, up next we have one that I can't lie, I am pretty excited about. Storybook Weaver Deluxe.
You can even use your own pictures if you are so inclined, as well as record your own voice using the in-program voice recorder. I've messed around with this for a bit, but I think I am now ready to create my own full-length story. I don't know if the world is ready for this, but here we go anyway.
Is this working? Okay. Adventures on the Oregon Trail by Peebo Hargrove. We bought a lot of supplies. Now we can start our journey. The journey started with some troubles. Plessy was very mad with the group leader, Big James Jr. Luckily, Big James Jr. always keeps his cool, no matter what the circumstance.
Hello.
While Plessy wasn't watching, her only child, Timifer, walked into an oblivion portal that had just appeared without her even noticing. Little James Jr., who was supposed to be watching Timifer, felt real bad about it.
Oops.
The group stopped by a lake located next to a school playground in New Jersey. Plessy waded into the waters in order to breathe no more breaths, for she was stricken with grief over her only son, Timifer, who died probably in the Oblivion portal from the Elder Scrolls. Little James Jr. was upset.
What?
But Big James Jr. kept his cool as always.
Hello.
The group stopped to play a baseball game. Everyone was happy, if only for a short while.
Hello.
Little Moraine, who was small even for her age, was up to bat. Tinker McGee, who was normally known to be the best pitcher this side of Coppertown, was off his game today. He wound up a pitch and...
Ouch!
Ever the cool, forgiving soul, Big James Jr. tried to keep the spirits up with a little encouragement.
Well done.
The group finally made it to Oregon. It was everything they ever dreamed. It even had a killer water park. After just a few hours, the police showed up to take away and execute Tinker McGee for tax evasion and serial identity theft crimes.
Uh-oh.
Not because of killing the kid. They didn't know about that. Big and Little James Jr. were resting after this strenuous journey when all of a sudden, the literal ghost of Plessy appeared and chucked Little James Jr. into the world of death.
Hello.
Because of how he didn't watch Timifer that one time earlier before. Big James Jr. was finally a broken man after having lost his entire Oregon Trailing group. So he walked out to the fields one dark night and put an end to his suffering. He paused for a moment before uttering his final words.
Hello.
Just after that happened, the Oblivion Gate reappeared. Timifer walked out unharmed. But everyone was dead now. Kinda like in that Stephen King book where there's a bunch of aliens inside of a fog, except not really because a kid died in that one and not the other guy, and it was a little different in a few other ways also. The end. Also, this other girl never got it into the story because I forgot to copy-paste her onto the second page. Oops. Okay, the end's for real now. Also, here's a buff six-armed man I probably should have added to the story because that would have been pretty sweet. Okay, bye.
Well, that sure was something. Well, on to the next something, McDonaldland Silly Games. You know it's gotta be good if it comes in one of these old, huge PC boxes. Let's open this thing up. Wait, it comes with a free Happy Meal coupon? We have to open this thing up ASAP. There we go. Oh, here it is. McDonald's. McDonaldland Software for Kids. Free Happy Meal. I wonder if this thing still works. Expires December 31st, 1998. Just missed it.
Install. Run. Wow. The Happy Meal Workshop. What an honor to see the famous McDonald's goop being made in person.
Hey! Hello to all my McDonaldland visitors. What a great day for playing games.
The man, the myth, the legend himself, Ronald freaking McDonald. This is just the
most disturbing thing I've seen in a while, honestly. I'm getting some serious Five Nights at Freddy's vibes from Birdie over here.
Hello to all my McDonaldland visitors. What a great day for playing games.
You just said that, Ronald. I'm no longer impressed with you.
We have so many things you can do here at McDonaldland. I can hardly wait to show you around.
It's actually pretty jarring to me how much Ronald talks in this. I don't remember him doing much of anything growing up other than brainwashing children into eating his crack-laced hamburgers and french fries. Well, that and occasionally breakdancing. Out of all the things he says in this game, though, my favorite by far would have to be... Alright, there's four games to play in McDonaldland Silly Games, assuming you don't count Mix and Match, which... I don't. Let's start with...
Jump and Slide. Great choice. Who do you want to be?
Oof. Ronald hitting us with the deep questions right off the bat, I see.
I guess I always wanted to be a YouTuber with 2 million subscribers when I grew it up, but that's probably not gonna happen. I don't know... Pizza?
I think I'll play as,
Remus.
Against the computer player.
Hamburgle.
My favorite characters, Remus and Hamburgle. This little virtual board game is essentially chutes and ladders. You roll the wheel at the top and watch what happens.
Hamburglar's turn.
Four.
Pretty exciting stuff.
There is literally no strategy in this at all. In fact, Ronald himself even admits as much.
If you're trying to come up with a strategy, forget it. It's all in the spin of the radar.
And this is in the strategy section of the help page, by the way.
Hey, congratulations, you won.
Whoa, I'm the jump and slide champion?
Yes.
Yes. I've never been so happy in my entire life.
Except for when I use my first fly bar, of course. Nothing tops that.
And up next we have...
Domino's. Great choice.
Welcome to my treehouse. When you're ready to start playing dominoes, just click on the dominoes and we'll get started.
Help!
It looks like Birdie has a stalker. Or two? Okay, make that three!
I'd say we should report these guys to Ronald, but I wouldn't bother because,
I'm pretty sure he likes it.
Click on the dominoes you want.
As you can see, I put a lot of planning and thought into this.
Okay, here we go! Domino time!
Congratulations, you won!
Hey everybody, I wanted to show you my newest amazing thrift store find.
Mega clip art for Windows, 7,000 color images.
3, 2, 1, go! Running, biking, sunning, hiking, gunning, typing.
Do you need a million cats?
I've got some clips for that.
Go score a touchdown, put on a pretty gown. Creep
creepy clown. I think I'm gonna die.
Try my mincemeat pie.
Ping pong, piggy pee. Hey, please call on me. Praying for the things you do. Pointing a gun at you. Old man trying to flirt. Pulling on mommy's skirt. Yummy beer, high gear. Happy freaking new year. Learning how to hack. Hey, that clown is back. I'm dead.
Hey everybody, Peeps here, and welcome back to the 8th installment of Goodwill Games, the show where I buy a bunch of stuff at the thrift store and then make you look at it. Specifically in the case of this series, games! I know it's a very complicated concept, just try and stick with me here, okay? Sometimes during the intro I joke about how not good the games are, and realistically they are, more often than not, not. But with any luck, we might just have a good one today. We'll have to wait and see. Well, it was better than Mario teaches typing, but I don't really know if that's saying all that much. Let's move on to the next game. Burp! Barbie and her sisters, Puppy Rescue! I know what you're thinking, maybe this one's gonna be good. Let me just go ahead and stop you right there. Hey everybody, and welcome to this week's episode of my new show called My Blog. As you already know, I work very hard on YouTube videos every day, and I can prove it. I'm gonna take you behind the scenes so you know what I'm all about. Let's go.
Right, there we go.
Break time!
Here's Rappin' Rockin' Barbie.
You can sing along.
Cause with her boombox, you can rap a song.
Hit it!
I brought the wrong Barbie to the Rappin' Rockin' Club. All the other girls are gonna beat me up.
And after you bring back a rescued puppy and take care of them, they go into the kennel where we get to wait! Seriously!
I literally fell asleep while playing this game. And by playing this game, I mean I was sitting there waiting. Because that's a big part of it, actually.
And then you do it all over again, ad infinitum, with absolutely no payoff as far as I can tell. Barbie and her sister's Puppy Rescue is just about the most boring game I've ever played. I would place it in a category of games I like to call non-games. You can barely even call it a game.
All right, Barbie, let's get the heck out of here. I want to play Barbie Cowgirl or something more exciting than this. Heck, I'd settle for Rapping Rockin' Barbie Rhythm Game or something stupid like that.
Wait a second. There's no way to get out of this town. All the exits are blocked off. Oh God, this is not good. This is not good. What's wrong with all these people? They're just walking in circles. They just walk in circles over and over. This is the same person. Sir, are you okay? Okay.
Up next, we have an actual fun game, Microsoft 3D Movie Maker. And yes, you heard me right. We have ourselves a good game. Create a new movie? Work on an old movie? Watch a movie? Make a movie with Melody? Get an idea for a movie? Go to Imaginopolis? Quit? That's a lot of things.
Hey, that was excellent. What should we do now?
Okay.
Well, I'm confident that we can at least make a better movie than that, but first, while doing a little bit of research online, I found an updated version of this game. Apparently, somebody made a version of the game that not only runs on modern computers, but is also moddable. And there's a seemingly endless amount of things you can add, anything from popular characters to a Game Boy border to freaking guns. So obviously, I had to use this version. I downloaded a bunch of mods and new characters and stuff and created what is sure to be the next masterpiece, not just video. Not just movie, but a film. Let's watch it.
Let's just all pretend that we didn't see that, okay?
Unfortunately, I didn't have this game growing up, but considering how much I loved making stupid movies throughout my childhood, I can safely say I would have loved it. I think it may even be my new favorite game that we've played on Goodwill Games. If you think it sounds interesting, go check it out. And I suppose with that, we've wrapped up another episode of Goodwill Games. I just have this one final bye-bye movie to show you.
Hey everybody, it's me, Sonic the Hedgehog. Make sure you like the video and subscribe, and if you don't, that's no good. No, but seriously, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye! Hey everybody, Peeps here. Things have been a little tight recently due to, events. Things completely outside my control that have absolutely nothing to do with my recent hobby of buying expensive things off eBay. So, completely unrelated to that, we're gonna be doing another Goodwill Games video where we play games that I found at the thrift store for next to nothing. And on top of that, in order to help out, I'm also selling some stuff if you're interested. I found some stuff at the thrift store you're definitely gonna want. Very valuable stuff. Place your bids in the comments below for this one-of-a-kind
grand piano, the sock master.
Now you can't put on your socks, but instead with a stick.
And I can't forget the Weber twins, Ashley and Sydney.
Sydney's not quite as smart as me, and not quite as pretty as me. And she's not as good at video games as I am. And she's certainly not half the tennis player I am. But she does the best with what she's been given.
Wow! That's not even true, by the way. Sydney is by far the best twin.
Oh my God! Sydney! It went through the wall! Goal of the century!
I stand Sydney.
It looks like the keeper was completely fooled by that shot.
Yes! We're gonna make the championships! Yeah!
What?
Your classmate must have been absent that day.
Wait, they got it wrong?
Even the fifth graders can't save you this time.
What kind of lifeline is that?
Look, if I'm gonna sit here and be patronized by small children, they better at least know what they're talking about.
Come on, just think about it and you'll do it.
Just think about it and you'll do it? What the heck does that even mean? What kind of advice is that?
You're not helping, Ard. If anything, you're distracting me with that freaking creepy stare. You can tell they're just guessing, too, because they write the answer down a split second after the question is asked. I mean, just look at this.
Here's the question.
Which of the following numbers is the smallest? And there we go! She's already written it down! I would say it's not humanly possible to have read both the questions and all four of those numbers fast enough to get an answer in that amount of time, but they're clearly not humans because humans blink!
Okay, the kids might be creepy, but let's be real here. At least they're not Jeff Foxworthy.
I knew that too.
Is he gonna say something like that every single time?
Yes.
Jeff!
You are not the fastest horse on the track.
Freaking.
Was grade school this tough for you the first time around?
Foxworthy!
I'm gonna guess that you spent a lot more time hanging out behind the library instead of in it.
Can go screw himself! I said it! Look, I get it. I'm stupid. Everybody already knows that anyway. Can we just go ahead and get on with it? If I was actually on the show playing for real money, putting up with all this BS would be one thing, but considering this is a video game and it's not even a good one, I'm just about done with this already.
The game hinges on this one final question.
God, I think I know this one. I think I know this one. It's...
Blind!
Okay.
Oh my God. He's so disturbing looking. I can't even barely look at it.
The games, let's just say, are not the most difficult challenges I've seen in my time. It's almost as if they think I'm some little kid. I don't know what would give them that impression. But if you want to learn even more, you can click on one of these little question marks on the map area to get a lesson with Brenda Blue, who I can only assume is these sentient machine beings' pet human.
You're an alphabet expert.
Why, thank you, small plane child. I am 30 years old.
So that's JJ the Jet Plane Sky Heroes to the Rescue, and that's the end of this episode of Goodwill Games. I'm really excited to eventually do the next episode, which will mark the 10th episode of Goodwill Games, one of my personal favorite series that I do on this channel. So thank you everybody who's been supporting me all this time, liking the video, subscribing, commenting, but a big extra special thanks to the highest bidders in the comment section on my thrift store items. I will be spending all the proceeds that I earn from that on anti-aircraft weaponry. Thank you!
Hey everybody, thanks for coming into my 10th episode of Goodwill Games special video. I'd like to thank my mom. If she had never given birth to me, I could never have made as moderately successful as YouTube series on the internet. Thank you, thank you, thanks mom!
You did it! You did it! Yeah, you did it!
Thanks.
Hey everybody, welcome back to another video, and thank you so much for watching my 10th episode of Goodwill Games. These Goodwill Games episodes have always been some of my favorites to make. Going to thrift stores is actually one of my favorite pastimes, and I love finding random games I know nothing about and sharing whatever happens with you guys. In fact, I love going to the thrift store so much that I decided that I'm gonna do a brand new Goodwill series on this channel, something that's not Goodwill Games or Goodwill Garbage, so keep a lookout for that very soon. And hey, maybe even subscribe if you don't wanna miss those videos. And maybe like the video while you're at it. I hate to do this, but this video took absolutely forever to make. Normally I would do three games
for these videos, but considering this is the 10th episode, I figured we could play 10 games. So, needless to say, it's going to take a while. So go grab some popcorn and then eat it. And then come back to watch this insanely long episode. Let's go!
There's alien balloons! How did Pep have and or lose alien balloons? Now that I think about it, this is actually a potential disaster. I saw a documentary one time about the Cleveland Balloon Fest, and that did not go well. Two people even died because of it, and no, I am not making that up. Putt-putt, Pep, you need to listen to me. This is important. Unless you want the death of innocence on your hands, because if you're complete and competence, we have to pop all of these balloons. Everyone is counting on us to do it!
Actually, I don't wanna. This game's boring.
There's an absolutely insane amount of tutorial in this game. They just go on and on and on. When do we get to the part where we start messing people up?
I mean, protecting and serving? Or whatever our job is, I don't know.
Admittedly, I probably should have paid more attention, but I just don't have the brain capacity to listen to these guys for one more second. So let's just get into the action. I'm sure I can figure it out. What the? How long have you guys been sitting here for? Jeez, they're freaking me out.
Especially the ginger.
Ginger didn't know what to do because it froze being a and so she decided to take a trip down the seeker path. She found some mushrooms on the seeker path and it helped her to think more clearly. On the secret path, she saw many things. She saw puzzles that she had to do in order to solve whatever you do in this game. I don't really know. She looked at different kinds of birds, and there's even a horse. But things didn't stay pleasant for long, eventually turning sinister.
Dude, this is kind of creepy, actually. Like, what if... Oh! What is that?
That owl had a secret stone! Holy shit! Hey, don't just drop it! That's important! Stupid fairy!
My only real problem with secret paths to the sea is that the lessons it teaches aren't exactly consistent. For example, this girl's story is listen to your parents, they know what's best. Even if you don't want to do what they want you to do, you should just do it anyway. But with this girl, it's if you don't want to do what your parents want you to do, then tell them you don't want to do it because you shouldn't have to do it.
Cut it out with the mixed messages game. I'm depending on you to tell me what to do throughout my adolescent female life. I've never been a young girl before, okay?
Oh yeah, and sometimes it glitches. But honestly, that adds more to the experience than it subtracts, if you ask me.
May I help you plant the fields again? Leloy strong bra-
What?
Alright, let's go from a game that I'm too old to be playing to a game that I'm way too old to be playing. Cheerios! Yes, Cheerios.
Ready to have some fun?
Yes!
Click here for help. 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 Click here for help.
I wasn't able to pick up one of those new fancy graphics cards, and my PC is chugging trying to run this game. So we're gonna have to get through this pretty quick. Let's make some Cheerios!
First, you have to unload the oats from the truck.
Okay.
Is this how cranes work? It's like, oh wait, no, we don't need it over here, dude. You're dropping the wrong place. Oh, my bad. Let's just go ahead and, there we go.
So are these crane physics part of the abstract reasoning the back of the box promises to teach us?
I mean, it is pretty abstract.
So we go step by step through the process of making Cheerios, and I'll give the game one thing. I've learned a lot. I've learned that Cheerios come from the Cheerios Queen and are birthed out one... at a time, very slowly.
In fact, making Cheerios is a slow process just in general. Did you know that only 12 Cheerios can be baked in the Cheerio oven at a time? Yes. And only 5 whole Cheerios are put into each box. Back in the good old days, they were a little more generous, but times are tough for cereal companies now. And when making one individual Cheerio takes this long, you gotta cut costs wherever you can. And I learned that they hire 0 employees in their factory, preferring to let children ages 3 to 5 pull the levers and activate the grabby hands that close up the boxes. You don't have to pay children ages 3 to 5 because hiring children ages 3 to 5 is illegal. Find out how they get away with this practice in the upcoming sequel, Cheerios Corporate Legal Loopholes Time, coming soon for the Nintendo Switch. I probably don't even need to explain this anyway. Everybody knows how this stupid game works. I'll take case number 8.
Now this is your
number 8.
5 minutes later.
All right, let's see. Case number 1.
Number 1.
Yes!
You know it's not good, right?
Yes! 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 Yes!
I don't think he knows how this game works.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Come on.
I don't really have that much to say about Deal or No Deal, other than whatever that was that I just did. I guess sometimes what you see is what you get.
Omniscient, all-powerful gods!
Are you winning, son?
I don't know, really. Our teachers Ben and Becky Brightly can turn into Clockhead, which I'm assuming is a boss in the next Silent Hill game. I guess I kind of forgot to mention what you actually do in this game. Well, you go from area to area and collect stars. It's basically Mario 64, except there's no this or this. Or Mario, and you do kindergarten. Other than that, it's basically the same game.
Hi. Welcome to LEGO Creator.
Okay, hold up. Why did they make this character a wizard, but give him just the most normal guy voice of all time?
Hey, click on something to find out what it does.
All right, everybody, shut the heck up. We got the next game, and it's a big one. Are you ready for this? We Cheer 2! This is almost as big of a deal as Cheerio, but not quite. No, it is. It is. Get hype.
We Cheer 2!
From the creators of some of my unironic favorite Wii games, Wii Ski and Snowboard and Go Vacation. But this is no vacation. This time, we're serious. This is cheerleading.
Screw mathematics and William Shakespeare. The time for cheering is here. Grab your Wiimote, make sure your space is clear. Greg is drawing near. He's been banned from the football team because he punched some kid in the spleen. And now he is dead, so he's coming for your place on the cheer team. So he's coming for your place on the cheer team. Every year the cheer team never wins and takes it on their chins. So he'll replace all these pathetic has-beens with his 5 identical twins. Greg and Greg and Greg and Greg and Greg and Greg will run this school forever, fuck yeah! I wish Greg would stop staring at me. I wish Greg would please stop staring at me. He's coming for your place on the cheer team. He's coming for your place on the cheer team.
Hi, I'm
the poop spider. Given that this is Mia's language adventure, we're gonna be learning a new language and we can choose between either French or Spanish. Considering I've taken a lot of Spanish classes in the past, I'm gonna go ahead and pick that one and hope I can remember at least a little bit of it. First thing on the agenda is saving this guy, whose name is literally Dingbat. Pretty epic troll on his mother's part, I have to say. Oh my god, I'm going insane and it's only the first mini game. This stupid frog's voice is gonna haunt me while I try to sleep tonight.
Frankenstein!
So Mia goes through a door very normally. If you answer incorrectly... I can't help but wonder, though, how are they gonna get back? I mean, they're kind of far away from their home. They took some pretty drastic measures to get over here.
And so, Mia, Grandma, and Romaine made the dangerous trek back to the inside of the house. They quickly came across the devil ants Mia had put to sleep 30 minutes earlier. But unfortunately for them, devil ants are very efficient nappers and woke up just as they were attempting to sneak past them.
Hurry!
Grandma and Romaine were quickly overtaken by the ant army, and Mia could hear their screams as she skateboarded away as fast as she could. She managed to hide in a clay pot for a brief moment, but it was no use. The ants surrounded her.
The end.
Bye!
I originally thought that this was the last Mia game, but apparently there was another Mia game in 2007 called Mia's Reading Adventure, but I've never actually seen that one before. So maybe one day I'll find it and we can talk about it in another video. Who knows? We'll see. So that is the 10th episode of Goodwill Games. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked it. And if you did, please like the video. This took a long time to make. And subscribe to see the new Goodwill series that I'm gonna come out with soon. I'm really excited about it. Check out another Goodwill Games, or you can watch me play a few of these games live on this video on the Peeps channel. See you guys next time. Mm-hmm.